Hey, YouTubers, welcome back to Galactic Gaming. This is Hatfield 15 reporting for duty, and today we are back with some more Metroid Samus Returns. Last time we played this game, we went back to areas 2 and 3, and we got all the items there. So as you guys can see, I just kind of generally made my way down to area 4 after collecting that last item. Okay, we've got quite a bit of item collecting to do in this area, and I can see there's one not too far from here, and I think there's like a... It's either a super missile door or a plasma beam door, so let's head on to it. So just before we begin, you guys, can this video please hit 15 likes? And if you're watching this and you're not subscribed, please be sure to smash that subscribe button if you want a shout-out. Be sure to show your subscription to me publicly if you want to make sure you get a shout-out. So without further said, we're all systems go for this video. In 3, 2, 1, let's do this. Okay, I remember Area 4. Area 4 was quite a doozy because, yeah, there was just generally quite a bit of stuff going on here in Area 4. I mean, this is where we got the spazer, super missiles, and even the space jump. And, of course, that's where we got chased down that giant hallway by the digger knot, in which eventually we would get revenge on it. Okay, is that the way? I do not know the way at the moment, but I shall find the way. Okay, there's a plasma beam door just right up ahead. Okay, yeah, I forgot there's those things that'll just come out of holes in themselves for a moment. Oh, yeah, and then, of course, I forgot. This is where we originally fought the Aeon Sappers, in which, of course, you have gotten me again. Okay, yeah, I couldn't find the plasma beam door for a moment, but, of course, I remember it's right up here. Okay, let's just go ahead and... Okay, I thought I detonated a power bomb, but no, that was just a regular bomb. Okay, yeah, it is a plasma beam door, so we're gonna go ahead and blast that. All right, now let's just go ahead and see what's through here. Okay, apparently this is going to be like a phase drift. This is going to be one of them phase drift obstacles. So, you know what? I'm not too disgruntled about that. Obviously, it's just going to be a little bit more of a challenge to get to here. Now, of course, I'm probably going to go ahead and scan pulse the area first, just to kind of reveal what's ahead. Oh, okay, I thought I could shoot all those things before they came at me, but no, I guess not. All right, doesn't look like our item should be too far ahead. Okay, I wonder what's right here. Maybe is that, yeah, it's another instant crumble block. So, you know, it might be a little bit more of a challenge to actually get up to this area. But you know what? I think I know what one must do. You have to do quite a bit of running, and I think there should be a grapple beam, like a point where you could grapple beam up at that one moment, like where it's about to kick you off, like where those crystals are. I think, again, like I said, I think I now know what I'm supposed to do. So let's actually hope this works. Come on. Again, I wonder, like, I'm sure it is somewhere up there. I'm just having a little bit of trouble actually getting to it. Alright, let's go ahead and destroy that snail so that it doesn't bother us later on. I mean, baby Metroid, you could be a little bit more useful and actually sap the life force out of some enemies, so it can make my job just a little easier. Oh yeah, of course there's those things right over here. Alright, okay, actually, wait, let's try and screw attack our way along. Yeah, it looks like it's gotta be, like, it has to be a grapple object. I'm not sure what else it would be. Yeah, I'm really not sure how one would get past that. I mean, oh yeah, I think I know the way. Our power bombs can get, like, it can boost us up quite a significant way. Like, it'll boost us up, like, quite a ways, like, give us quite a boost. So I wonder if maybe this is one of those obstacles where we gotta use our power bomb boost. Okay, let's see. Second last block should be a good place to go. Alright, now let's just go along this fast. Okay, crap, I didn't think that was gonna work. Those blocks are crumbling, like, way too fast, so there must be... Okay, I've already gone through, like, half my Aeon, but I will not give up. Maybe we actually do need to kind of screw attack our way along. Oh, yeah, of course I remember there's also lightning armor that we've got. So maybe lightning armor should be able to protect us from those crystals. I'm not sure if it'll do a 100% good job, but we'll see what happens. All right, go up the thing, Samus. Phase drift off. Oh, okay, I just saw that grapple point right over there. Okay, that would have made my job a lot easier had I actually spotted that earlier. There's a little point where you could grab onto, and then you could actually grapple beam up. Okay, again, like I said, had I seen that earlier, I would have wasted a lot less Aeon. But anyways, we now finally have that obstacle. Okay, I don't care whether you deactivate my Aeon for a moment or not, I'm just gonna straight up go ahead and recover that Aeon. And plus, I have a reserve tank in case you don't know. I thought there was gonna be something right up there, but let's see. Okay, there must be, like I said, our next obstacle, our next item, rather, should be just somewhere along here. Of course, I'm having trouble trying to find how to get to it. Well, maybe there's... Yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and scan pulse. Maybe it would reveal something. Alright, I'm hearing some stuff. So, Oh, okay, there's these blocks right here, but I'm looking for blocks that would lead me to... Oh, wait a minute. I think I might know. There's a way... I see it. There's a way around here. So, I remember I was on my way down here from Area 4. Oh, yeah, that's right. This is like a space jump thing. Okay, there's a spacer door right over there. Okay, so that's how you get to that. That's how you get to that missile expansion right there. Okay, so you're supposed to have... Again, I was checking how many items you're supposed to have by the end of the game. So, 264 missiles, 35 super missiles, and 20 power bombs. I don't see how many energy tanks we get, but like I said, there's like an item counter for each area in the game, essentially. So, of course, that'll just kind of give us some more hints on how many items we're supposed to have for each area. Alright, let's see. Okay, there seems to be, like, maybe one or two items. I'll check that other room where it looks like there's another artifact right over there. Okay, no, maybe not necessarily an artifact, but maybe... Yeah, this is probably... That's the place I'm trying to go for is probably where we got, like, the phaser or whatever. Okay, I'm just gonna equip myself with lightning armor. Okay, yep, it's another one of these things. Oh, I think I see how this works. You were supposed to go around, blop a bomb. Okay, I'm not sure... How you're supposed to blop this bomb? Okay, wait, I think I might know. Lightning armor? Wait a minute. I think I know. Let's just wait for that thing to come out again. Ice beam? Good. Missile? Better. Alright, good. That's how we do that. Ice beam isn't totally... I guess the ice beam totally isn't totally useless after you've kind of beaten the game through and you're just going back collecting all the items. Okay, like I said, I'm not sure... Yeah, I doubt there'd be any items where the phaser was collected, but you know, we're just going to go ahead and take a look at it anyways, just to be safe. Yeah, this is definitely the room where we got the phaser. Oh, yeah, of course, there's that Aeon orb in which we just totally refueled our Aeon supplies. Well, that's good. Okay, there's something else just right by where that missile expansion was. Okay, yeah, I just saw it. Just try and get that square on the map done, so that's not an issue. All right, there's a place where we fought a Metroid right down below. Okay, I also remember Area 4 is also where we fought our first Zeta Metroid just shortly after we got chased by the Diggernaut. That wasn't a very pleasant chase, I'm not gonna lie, but hey, we survived it anyway. Of course, on my own separate file, because I have two files for this game. I'm just playing one on my own spare time here. Obviously, I died, and of course I learned the hard way that it's instant death for if you touch it. Alright, now let's see. Okay, of course we gotta go that way around. Okay, it looks like it's gonna be a phase drift obstacle right here. Oh, never mind. I remember. This is actually where we fought that last Alpha Metroid. I think this might have been where we fought, like, the last Alpha Metroid in the game. Actually, no, I take that back. There was a little spot... Yeah, I think there was that little spot in Area 5 where we fought that Alpha Metroid. Otherwise, that was it. I mean, fighting Alpha Metroids, like your first time, a couple times fighting Alpha Metroids, it's a bit of a challenge, obviously, because you're still kind of like getting used to the game. But once you just move on and collect more and more useful upgrades and stuff, Alpha Metroids, they're basically like nothing. All right, phase drift. Here we go. All right, cool. We made it. Now we're just going to be a little careful because you never know when there could be more phase drift blocks to just set you right back to where you started. But anyways, that's our... God, I don't know what it is, because we started off with, like, I don't know, like 20, 30-ish missiles. Well, in the original Metroid 2, you start off with, like, 30 missiles. And, of course, I've forgotten how many missiles you have in the beginning of this game. Well, it's somewhere around the 30 mark. That's pretty much all I can confirm at the moment. All right, there's an item or two right down over there, but I just want to try and focus on this area of Area 4 and then move on to this area. Yeah, boom. Okay, I can see there's a whole bunch of, Okay, there's a couple of missile expansions and an Aeon expansion. This is the place where we got chased by the Diggernaut originally, so that's why we weren't able to collect those. A, because some of them couldn't be accessed without the baby, because there were some of them that were blocked by crystals. And B, we were just trying to keep our booty from being sliced up by the Diggernaut. Yeah, we were just kind of running for our lives. I mean, I'm sure there is a way, like, it could have collected them otherwise. Oh, okay, I was hoping I could try and not get my Aeon abilities deactivated, but hey, I'm totally overpowered without my Aeon abilities by this point in time, so I suppose it's not really that big a deal. Alright, die. Alright, good, die. I'm not sure, like, robots aren't exactly living creatures, they're just machines. Like, they're not exactly, like, sentient. Well, unless you give them artificial intelligence or whatever. But, you know, it's not exactly, like, telling them to die, that's a bit of an awkward thing, because they're not exactly, like, living creatures, kind of like a bunch of other creatures in here in our universe. Oh, yeah, I forgot there were also some baby crystals right over there, but I don't think that could lead us to an item. Yeah, it doesn't look like it's gonna lead us to an item, but hey, you know what? I suppose we'll actually just go ahead and check out what's down here. Anyways, is there something? Okay, no, there isn't something. Oh, wait, I think this is where, yeah, I'm pretty sure, yeah, according to my map, this is where we got one item, but hey, we've had that item for, like, a long time now, because there's a little dot on our map indicating that we've already gotten it. Okay, wow, I don't know why those crystals are moving. Okay, it looks like it's a part of, like, a much bigger creature, so that only makes a whole load of sense right there. Yeah, of course, like, originally these guys were fun to melee counter, but of course we're now just kind of screw attacking our way through them all. Of course, we can still hit them with the parry when we feel like it, but of course it's not too much of a challenge right there. I mean, with some enemies, yeah, obviously you can parry them, and other enemies, you can't. Like, those one enemies that I kept complaining about for a while, like, they're, like, the ones that were, like, hella annoying. Okay, I thought I saw something right down there, but of course it was nothing. It was maybe just this noble little Aeon Sapper right over there. Alright, we shouldn't be too far away from this next item. Like, it should be just somewhere within the next room or so. Oh, yeah, this is where we fought a Gamma Metroid. Ah, yes, here is the way. Oh, okay, no, wait, that just brought us right around. So I'm not sure how you got this item. Okay, wait, I see a little drop point. Like, I see a little point right here. So is this? Okay, of course we need to hit it with the missile block and then just try and go at it real fast. We actually get it. So, blah. Alright, good, we've got that missile expansion now. I don't know why. Oh no, I suppose we couldn't get here without space jump. And of course, we got space jump in this area. So that makes sense why we weren't able to get it earlier. Okay, I'm not sure. Yeah, we've got like half the items. I wasn't sure. You know, I'm not overly sure how you get that item right over there. But let's head back up to the little sub area right over here where we fought that Gamma Metroid. Okay, wait, I don't know why I'm not seeing the Gamma Metroid icon, like the defeated Metroid icon. Oh, wait, I forgot it was a Gamma Metroid, so they're obviously just running around the place trying not to die. That makes sense why it wouldn't be in this room now that I think about it, because of course I remember that Gamma Metroids, they would just run from room to room in these little tunnels right over here. Yeah, you don't fight a Gamma Metroid for quite a while. Like, I don't think I've fought a Gamma Metroid since, like, Area 6-ish? Yeah, about Area 6, I haven't fought a Gamma Metroid since then, because it's mainly been Zetas, Omegas, and of course there's that one Queen. Oh yeah, then of course there is also the little, like, normal Metroids, like the ones that, like, the one, like, this evolutionary phase right here, like, some people call them Larva Metroids, but they don't exactly seem like larva to me. Like, they seem pretty freaking big at times. So, yeah, let's just say normal Metroids. Yeah, normal Metroids. Of course, like, it's been mainly, like, since Area 6, it's mainly been Zetas, Omegas, of course, there was that one little place in Area 8 where it was the normal Metroids. Sorry, I already forgot what I was calling them. So, like, normal Metroids, and of course, there was that one Queen Metroid, and then after that, we got the cute little baby right over here, in which for now is just kind of backtracking to all the areas, collecting everything. Alright, baby, can you eat those crystals? Like, I'm not sure, like, what is it about those crystals that you like so much? I mean, you seem to eat pretty much every crystal we walk by, so it must mean something. Okay, I feel like there must be something right over here, and I think we may have just found that little something that brings us over to here. Aha! Alright, cool, you just gotta look for them secret passageways sometimes. It's a good thing my plasma beam passes through literally everything. Okay, there's a thing right there that was, it might have been active at one point or another, but I don't think it's active now. But anyways, we've got that Aeon tank. It doesn't look like we'll need too many Aeon expansions from here on in, because our Aeon gauge is pretty close to maximize. Same thing with our energy tanks. I don't think we'll need too many energy tanks. Like, I think we'll only need enough energy tanks to make it to, like, the edge of our energy reserve tank right over there, which isn't too far. Alright, so 52.4% items. There's one item down there. Otherwise, I think we have everything. I'm just taking a close little look at the map just to make sure I have everything. Yeah, it looks like I've got everything for this wing of Area 4. Now, of course, going back to the room where we were chased by the digger, now that's going to be a little bit more of a doozy to try and collect those items there. Okay, I'm just going to go ahead and activate lightning armor just because I want safety. I mean, you can never want too much safety when you're playing Metroid, because some things are easier and some things are harder. Okay, yeah, I mean, I'm completely maxed out. I mean, I have the gravity suit. I have everything. Like, all Metroids are dead, but I don't know why I'm still getting hurt by those little, like, by the purple acid and such. Well, I suppose the purple acid was created in the first place to kind of keep you from going, like, to pretty much every area. Like, you're supposed to hit the Chozo seals, in which then it would actually unlock that area, as opposed to you just being able to run through that area. I mean, with the original Metroid 2, it was something like that, because you had to destroy a certain amount of Metroids, and then it would trigger, like, I don't know, like, maybe some kind of earthquake. Yeah, it must have been some type of earthquake that was triggered when you destroy all the Metroids for that area, then you would just move on. Then, of course, like I said, this is different from the original, because unlike the original Metroid 2, it actually indicates how many Metroids are in that area, as opposed to for it just leaving you to figure it out on your own. Okay, this is... Oh, yeah, I remember this. It was one of those things where it was, like, right by the elevator, and you had to find a way around it. All right. Is that going to be bomb block? Yeah, it's going to be a bomb block, but this time I'm actually not going to skip it. I'm just going to go ahead and figure out how the living hell you're supposed to get to it. Okay, of course, there's purple acid right over here. Oh, wait, I don't think I've been here, because I'm filling squares up as I go along. So, yeah, obviously I haven't been to this particular part of Area 4. Well, at least the exit zone. Okay, I don't trust those blocks. Like, something just doesn't exactly feel right about them. But, hey, we've made it here, so let's go ahead and see what type of item there is. Okay, I'm just... Alright, let's go ahead and scan Paul, see if we can try and find it. Aha! There it is! Let's see, is it a missile expansion? Okay, no, it's a super missile block, so we've got that. And coincidentally, it gives us a super missile. I mean, I like collecting items and all in a particular fashion, but it's almost like kind of dumb that when you have to destroy a missile block, it gives you a super missile, missile expansion. Same thing with super missiles. I mean, I find that kind of, not exactly the most entertaining thing in the world. All right, Squishy Baby, just follow along me, and I will show you the place where Mommy was chased by a giant freaking mining robot, which was a real pain in the booty to fight if you were like me and you didn't use Aeon. I mean, again, I would have used Aeon in a Digger Not fight, but I chose not to back then because I actually wanted to give myself a little bit of a challenge, because the Aeon abilities are very, very useful throughout Metroid Samus Returns, and of course they protected me from a lot of damage, like lightning armor. I mean, I would have died, like, if Aeon abilities hadn't existed, I would have died a lot more than I already have. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, I forgot there's a whole bunch of freaking space jump obstacles in this particular part of Area 4. Like, this particular part is, like, mainly space jump obstacles, because this is where, yeah, this is where we got chased by Diggernaut. So, just come with me, little baby, and I shall show you where I was chased by what is the most annoying enemy in the game. So, as you can see right here, baby Metroid, as we go along, I was just, okay, I thought I would be able to kill that guy before I'd have to parry it. Alright, little baby, as you can see, as we go along through this area here, this is where a whole bunch of stuff, like a whole bunch of crystals and whatever, used to be, but apparently it was all destroyed by the Diggernaut, because he was trying to kill me, for he perceived me as a threat. Okay, there we go, missile tank acquired. Okay, is this little drop-down point? Okay, well, I'll be dog. I think this is actually a little, like, drop-down point to the next little subspace right here, like the little next little subspace. Okay, I'm just dropping morphball bombs everywhere, see if I can try and find a way around. Oh, okay, here's a way around. But anyway, Squishy Baby, this isn't the way I was actually coming, like, the way we're walking, I was actually being chased from Diggernaut via that way. Of course, I could have easily collected, like, a couple of these items before Diggernaut tried to kill me, but, hey, like I said, I was just kind of in the middle of running for my life here. Alright, Aeon Gauge acquired, Aeon Tank acquired, Aeon Gauge increased. I should say that rather than what I just said right there. Okay, I could have gone and used my Morphball Bombs, but, hey, I've got pretty much every upgrade in the game now, including my cute little baby Metroid, because, yeah, baby is life. I mean, some people, like, I happen to know that some people aren't exactly fans of the baby Metroid, like, I can understand that. Okay, wait, there's another missile expansion right over here, so I wonder how one would exactly get to it. Alright, let's go ahead and scan Paul so I don't think we'll be needing that. Okay, we're supposed to get it from underneath ourselves, so that would make, perfect sense right over there. Oh, okay, oh yeah, I forgot this is like a little bit more of a sub area right here, so we had to hit a morphball bomb there, go along our way here, and then just destroy a few missile blocks, and of course we get chased by the Diggernaut again. So yeah, this is where the final phase of the Diggernaut chase kind of took place here. Oh yeah, of course it'd be a space jump obstacle, because pretty much everything in this particular part of Area 4 would be a space jump obstacle. Okay, I see where you're supposed to go now. I didn't see it at first, but I think I see it now. Okay, let's just go ahead and powerbomb, see what we can reveal. Oh, wait, I see. Oh, yeah, I see it. I see it. It was right over here. So now, powerbomb's away. I could have easily done that without using powerbombs, but hey, there we go. We've got that missile expansion, and I believe there is yet one more missile expansion not too far ahead, and this would be... Yeah, this would be along the final stretch of the Diggernaut chase, and this is kind of where I died because I couldn't react fast enough. Of course, I forgot which particular part it is in my spare file, because, yeah, I haven't been to this, obviously, in my separate file, I haven't been to this in my own spare time. Oh, okay, of course, I was talking about getting that missile expansion, and of course, I just about walked right by it. Okay, here's the way, here's how we get to it. We just simply drop a few more fall bombs, and boom, we've got our missile capacity increased by a little bit. Alright, 72%. The last little bit of our item should be right up ahead. I'm just gonna still go ahead and just cover all these areas anyway, just to kind of make sure I'm getting absolutely everything. Oh, did you see that? Like, I caught that guy. Like, I don't even think he was aiming properly at me. Okay, yeah, this is the part that killed me in my separate file. I wasn't able to react fast enough. Okay, of course this is where we're gonna have a little bit of a problem right over here, because... Bah! Okay, no, we're not gonna have a problem, hopefully. Okay, good, we're not gonna have a problem. Okay, I forgot how that part worked out. I mean, with Diggernaut, like, with the final phase of Diggernaut chase there, I could concentrate a little bit more. And, of course, right here, Squishy Baby is the place where I screamed as I hopped up into this little space here in which I was safe from the Diggernaut, in which it spat out the space jump upgrade. So now I can do stuff like this. You gotta teach your Metroid children what you went through at one point or another, so I just thought I'd go ahead and tell it those things right here, right now, because I was going through this entire planet exterminating its, what would be brothers and sisters, but had I not killed them or ever. Okay, and there's another item that's right up ahead. Now this is kind of the part where we got close to fighting our first Zeta Metroid, where we're getting close to it. Okay, of course I see an unexplored room right up ahead, so that's where we're gonna head off to. I mean, that was a really cool melee counter, because I caught it right on, like, the top edge of it, like, it was barely even touching the dude at that point. Like, it was just, go along it today. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, right! That's completely right. And of course, we've now gotta go around this way, in which we have to shoot it. Alright, let's just go ahead and parry that guy. I could have just shot him as normal, but, whatever. Alright, is this gonna be... Okay, good, it is open this time. I thought it wouldn't do a thing for a moment. But hey, we now have another super missile expansion. I think we're now... God, let's see, we're supposed to have 35-ish by the end of the game, and we've got 28. So I just need a quick moment to do my math. So 28, 35, so about 7-ish, that should sound about right, like about 7 more super missile expansions, and we've got all the super missile expansions in the game. Alright, I'm not sure what'd be down here, maybe there's something. Oh yeah, I forgot those little things sped up. Okay, of lightning armor. Alright, it doesn't look like anything, it's just like a little quick exit point where you can just get out quickly. But anyways, we gotta go up this way here, in which we can now just hit that guy, obviously. Okay, I think, yeah, this video's been going on pretty long, so I think I might only have to be able to do one area, one area in this episode. But hey, you know what, in the next couple episodes, I hope to try and get more and more items, obviously, and then just go ahead and end off the game. I hope to end off the game in maybe, like, I don't know, 2-3 more episodes. Oh, wait, I see how you get this one. I think I saw it was a powerbomb expansion, so, woo! Yep, powerbomb tank acquired, and we had to do that little powerbomb boost right over there. Like, that's really, like, don't get me wrong, that looks extremely cool and all. Of course, that destroys, like, absolutely any enemy that's unfortunate enough to encounter you in that point. But yeah, like, can you imagine what Samus must feel when she actually hits the edge of it or whatever? Like, it must be like extreme, like blunt force or whatever. But hey, Samus has been through quite a lot before Metroid 2. And of course, she'd have to go through a lot crazier stuff come the rest of the franchise. Like, you know, Super Metroid, Other M, Metroid Fusion is a big one. Okay, it doesn't look like there's a gravel point right there up there, so I just had to do some careful spin jumping, in which I'm now right over here. Okay, I thought I would have to parry that. Okay, yeah, not too far ahead would be the place where I fought my first Zeta Metroid, but let's see, how much have we got? 90-something percent items. Okay, I'm just taking a little glance around just to make sure I've got everything. Of course, there are some of those squares in which those might be items, but I'll go ahead and check them maybe after the end of the video, like when I'm just checking online maps or whatever and comparing it to my own. Oh, wait, I see it. I think I saw it. Yep, okay, cool. It's an energy tank. Of course, I'm not exactly needing energy tanks at this moment. Okay, those were just screw blocks, but hey, we've now got our first energy tank in a little bit since we fought the Metroid Queen. All right, is that it? Okay, 95%. Okay, I think I might know where our next item is. Okay, I think we only need, well, according to this, I think we might only need, like, I don't know, like, maybe one or two more energy tanks before our thing is completely full here. Of course, we gotta go back the long way, because apparently that was a one-way thing in which you can go through that one particular area, but of course, for some reason, the hatch is inactive. Well, I'm sure it was inactive so you couldn't get that missile expansion so easily. I mean, once you have that missile expansion, I think it should just become a regular door. Like, it shouldn't be, like, there shouldn't be any excess, like, extra obstacles or whatever. Like, it should just, you know, like, be a regular door. Like, it shouldn't be blocked on that end. Like, it should just, you know, just be there so it can do its thing and just open up. Ah! Let's see, are these bombs? Okay, no way, I see a hatch right up there. Okay, yeah, this is another one of those one-way points where we gotta go up one way. Oh, yeah, that's right, this is where we got super missiles, so I can expect there'd maybe be one more item somewhere along here. I've just gotta try and find that item is the issue here. Wait, I think I might, yeah, I see it, that's where our last item is. I thought I couldn't see it for a moment, like, I thought I'd have to take a look at my online maps to try and find it. Alright, it's gotta be, like, the entrance to it has to be somewhere along here, so let's go ahead, scan pulse it. I'm gonna scratch my head. Alright, can we hear the pinging of those blocks, so now we need to find the way to that item. Come on, let's see, where, how would one get to it? Oh, wait, maybe we've got a, ah, that's all we had to do. We just had to simply hit it with the super missile, and that would give us a super missile expansion. All right, good. That's it. That's pretty much all the items here for Area 7. So I'm just going to head on over to Area 5. This area, yeah, this area was a little bit bigger, so that's probably why I choose to only do one area in this episode as opposed to doing two areas per game. So, because I suppose those areas are a little bit short. But anyways, I'm probably going to go ahead and end off the video here. Maybe like one or like maybe one more energy expansion, like maybe a couple more Aeon tanks, and then just a little bit more stuff, and then we'll have everything in the game, guys. So just keep tuning in on to my fabulous episodes like you always do, and we'll see what happens in the next episodes to come. So for now, that's about all the time we've got today, so thank you all for joining me today. Be sure to subscribe, leave comments down below, because I like them, and crank that like button to the max like Soulja Boy. Till then, I'm Hatfield15. Space out, bros and brositas.